This video is a general guide of what documents to bring, what to wear, and what time to arrive at your U.S. citizenship interview. It should suit common cases. It is not for complex cases like those with arrests or convictions. Bring all documents you used in your N400 application and any documents mentioned in your appointment letter. The following is a general checklist. Only bring those that are applicable to you. All applicants must bring 1. Your interview appointment notice. 2. Your permanent resident card or form I-551. 3. A state-issued identification such as a driver's license, state ID, or a non-driver ID. 4. All valid and expired passports and travel documents issued to you that documents your absences from the United States since becoming a permanent resident. You also need to bring income tax return documents. Bring certified tax returns for the last 5 years or 3 years if you are married to a U.S. citizen. If you have ever failed to file an income tax return since you became a lawful permanent resident, bring all correspondence with the IRS regarding your failure to file. If you have any federal, state, or local taxes that are overdue, bring a signed agreement from the IRS or state or local tax office showing that you have filed a tax return and arranged to pay the taxes you owe, and a documentation from the IRS or state or local tax office showing the current status of your repayment program. Certified tax transcripts can be ordered by using IRS Form 4506T, available at www.irs.gov. or by calling 1-800-829-1040. If you are applying for naturalization based on marriage to a U.S. citizen, bring evidence that your spouse has been a U.S. citizen for the last 3 years, like your spouse's birth certificate if your spouse was born a U.S. citizen, or Form FS-240, report of birth abroad of a citizen of the United States of America. If your spouse is a naturalized U.S. citizen, you can bring his or her certificate of naturalization. Alternatively, you can also bring your spouse's U.S. passport. You also need to bring documents referring to you and your spouse. Example of these documents are tax returns, bank accounts, mortgages, leases, birth certificates of children, Internal Revenue Service certified copies of the income tax forms that you both filed for past 3 years, IRS tax return transcript for the last 3 years. If you were married before, bring proof that all earlier marriages ended, like divorce decrees, annulment certificates, death certificates. If you have a dependent spouse or child who is not living with you, bring any court or government order to provide financial support and evidence of your financial support, including evidence that you have complied with any court or government order. Examples are canceled checks, money and receipts, court or agency printout of child support payments, evidence of wage garnishments, letter from parent or guardian who cares for your child. If you have taken any trip outside the United States that lasted 6 months or more since becoming a lawful permanent resident, bring evidence that you and your family continued to live, work, and/or keep ties to the United States, such as an IRS tax return transcript or an IRS certified tax return listing tax information for the last 5 years or for the last 3 years if you are applying based on marriage to a U.S. citizen. Rent or mortgage payments. Pay stubs. If you are currently in the U.S. military service and are seeking citizenship based on that service, bring a completed original Form N-426, request for certification of military or naval service. If you did not register with the Selective Service and you are male, are 26 years old or older, and lived in the United States in a status other than as a lawful non-immigrant between the ages of 18 and 26, bring a status information letter from the Selective Service. Call 1-847-688-6888 for more information. If you have been involved in a traffic incident, bring documentation if your traffic incident involved alcohol or drugs, or led to an arrest, or seriously injured another person, or have fines greater than $500. It is recommended to bring documentation anyway, even if your traffic incident have lesser a fine. Examples are traffic ticket or violation documents, traffic fine payments, court documents if you went to court. If your current legal name is different from the name on your permanent resident card, bring documents that legally changed your name, like marriage certificate, divorce decree, court document. If you have been exempted from the English requirements, you may bring an interpreter to the interview, or USCIS may select one for you. The attorney cannot be your interpreter. They must be different people. People with language disability, or people over 50 or 55 years old and have lived in the United States as a permanent resident for at least 20 or 15 years respectively, may be exempted from the English requirements. If you are unable to take the full oath of allegiance, bring a letter from your church explaining how your religious beliefs prevent you from taking the full oath to your naturalization interview. You can bring an attorney or accredited representative who is acting on your behalf. You should have included Form G-28, Notice of Entry of Appearance as Attorney or Representative, when you submitted your N-400 application. If you are applying for a disability exception to the testing requirement, send an original Form N-648, Medical Certification for Disability Exceptions, completed less than 6 months ago, by a licensed medical or osteopathic doctor or licensed clinical psychologist, and bring the copy of this form during your interview. What to wear to your U.S. citizenship interview? There are no official dress requirements for the naturalization interview. You should dress comfortably and look professional. Business casual, business formal, smart casual, and semi-formal are good choices. For women, any of the following are recommended: business suit, dress shirt, dress pants, slacks, or skirts, blazer, scarf, flats, loafers, or heels. Recommended for men are business suit, dress shirt, khakis, trousers, slacks, sport coats, ties, dress shoes. Avoid wearing gym clothes, sweatpants, tank tops, jeans, shorts, shirts with offensive or political slogans or pictures, excessive perfume or cologne, distracting makeup or hairstyles. What time to arrive? Arrive early on your interview. Give yourself some extra time, but there is no need to arrive more than 15 minutes before your appointment or 30 minutes for naturalization ceremonies. Ensure that you have already familiarized yourself with the location. Plan your drive route, parking, or public commute. Be aware of the travel times, including traffic at the time of your travel. If you fail to show up on the day of your interview, USCIS could decide to administratively close your case. If that happens, USCIS will send you a letter with further instructions on your address on file. If you need to reschedule your appointment, follow the instructions on your appointment notice. There is no penalty to reschedule your appointment, but note that the next appointment can be several months later. Good luck with your interview. If you find this video helpful, please like and subscribe.